You have a serious interest in English literature. What do you have time to read? What are you reading right now?
Well, right now I'm not reading literature. I'm reading nonfiction, and there's two books I'd like to mention. One is The End of Power by Moises Naim, and I'm going to knit them together. And the other is a book by Douglas Rushkoff called Present Shock. I find them fascinating because in Moises Naim's book, The End of Power, we called him in to meet with the combatant commanders and the Joint Chiefs. And he challenged us by saying that the real problem we've got in moving forward in the use of military power, whether for deterrence or assurance or even conflict, is we're dealing not with strength on strength, but we're dealing with weakness. We're dealing with pervasive weakness in political structures, in economic structures, even in things like religious structures. And he describes a future where our ability to deal with weakness will define us more than our ability to deal with strength. It's a fascinating and frustrating thought. And then I'll link that one to this book called Present Shock, the first chapter of which describes the collapse of the narrative. And the collapse of the narrative is that we used to be more concerned about what would happen in the future. How do we build ourselves toward the future? What actions should we take today to create a narrative that helps us understand the future? And his thesis, not surprising by the title, is today it's all about today. It's all about right now. There's so much information that comes in. Probably while you're sitting here, if you had your BlackBerry on you, it would have vibrated. You'd have been tempted to look at it because you can. And so when you think about dealing with weakness and dealing with present shock, I think it helps illuminate the challenges we have today.